sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them. They turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart.
Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, Richard, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Would you kindly be seated for the reading of the Word of God?
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people. And God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or and mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give a gift from the spring of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Lord, O my soul, and all my being, bless God's name. Bless the Lord and forget not God's benefits. The Lord is kind and merciful. God pardons all your iniquities and comforts your sorrows, redeems your life from destruction and crowns you with kindness. The Lord is kind and merciful. Merciful and gracious is our God, slow to anger, abounding in kindness. The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful.
A second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, no one lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So when, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why then do you judge your brother? Or you, why do you look down on your brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God. For it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then each of us shall give an accounting of himself to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. From the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. After he sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, blessed are the poor in spirit, theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers. They will be called children of God. And blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Rejoice, be glad. Your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I'm going to give my homily from three places. Begin here. It's the story of God in that city of Jerusalem. And in the story of God from the beginning of the Old Testament, God was struggling to do everything he could to make sure that everyone would be welcome into his kingdom, into the new Jerusalem. And they even described out of the temple would come water flowing from the east. And that water flowing from the east was to give life to people, and then hopefully life eternal. Then Jesus sent his son. And his son, Jesus, came to earth to be able to give his life for the ransom of all, including Richard. The stories of the Old Testament prepared the kingdom to welcome Jesus. Stories of family feuds, and yet God remained with them. Stories of deception, yet God still shone forth. So Jesus came to destroy sin, to give life, eternal life. And the sacrifices of the Old Testament of bloody animals became the sacrifice of Jesus. And the altar became a table that would feed people. The altar came literally, Jerusalem, right in front of us, the priests and the people. We are always facing the east where that water would flow forth. And the desire of God was that he would be able to come down and literally have an impact on you and I, on Richard. And if you notice how scriptures talk about the Word made flesh, dwelt among us, the message that Jesus had was that he needed people, he needed you, he needed Richard to be present, to be able to be the physical sign of something very spiritual, his soul. And you will have to let go of that physical presence. And now you have to draw on the Spirit. I do not care if he made mistakes, sins in the language of the world, because the power of God is one that saves and redeems, forgives and heals. That is the power and the blessing that we are here to celebrate. Physical presence is important. And we know that flesh by its very nature has conflicts to it. Now let's come to the soul. Now you have a soul friend. You have someone that can still speak to you in ways if you open your ears in a spiritual way. That you have a soul friend who can still advise and comfort better than he ever did in flesh. You have a soul friend who will continue to walk with you. I hope challenge you to encourage the best parts of his life. And if there's an examination of conscience of him and all of you, I hope you heard it in the gospel. When the days he was mourned, he will be blessed for. The days that he was a peacemaker, he will be called children of God. All the days in which he is righteous and trying to do what is good and just. And those are the same characteristics that you and I are asked to follow. So we now turn him over to God. And we let that spirit, that soul, be raised up. And if any sins are committed, they are forgiven. My brothers and sisters, Jesus is risen from the dead, sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for Richard, for all of us. So we offer these intercessions. The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. In baptism, Richard received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now. Lead him over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. He was washed and nurtured by the Savior. Welcome into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord. We pray for Vincent. We pray for the family members. We pray for all present here, that we may find the gifts that he gave us and that we attempt always to imitate them, we pray to the Lord. We bring an awareness of our world, an awareness of struggles that take place in the Middle East, place in Ukraine, other parts of the world. Lord, accomplish what we are incapable of accomplishing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for family members who have gone before and awaited the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let's pause for a moment that each of us might reflect on an intention that we would like to make. And for the intentions of all gathered here, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray. Lead us and guide us, Lord, into your way, your truth, and your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Would you kindly be seated?
I will come to you in the silence. I will lift you from all your fear. You will hear my voice. I claim you as my choice. Be still and know I am here. I am hope for all who are hopeless. I am eyes for all who long to see. In the shadows of the night, I will be your light. Come and rest in me. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me. I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine.
it, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of Richard, we beg your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge through Christ our Lord. And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right, it is just, it's our duty, it's our salvation, that we always and everywhere give you thanks through Jesus your Son. In him the hope of the blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed and not ended. When this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. With angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, and without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Dennis and Joseph, our Bishop, your clergy, and all your sons and daughters. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. And remember your servant, Richard, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in the resurrection. We remember the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, St. Teresa, St. Richard, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and God, glory and power is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
This time we join together in the words that Jesus himself gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, safe from all distress, as we wait in the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom and the power
and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
In my homily, I mentioned at this altar the sacrifice of Jesus dying in Jerusalem is really reenacted every time we gather for Mass. And I said the altar then becomes a table. And it feeds those who have made their first communion and continue to live in that life of worthy. And if you are of a different faith tradition or background during the time of communion, I would ask you simply to pray to yourself that God will nurture you in ways that are truly appropriate. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. I don't need it. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. If anyone is receiving communion, they can come forth.
One bread, one body, one Lord of all.
Body of Christ.
One cup of blessing which we bless. And we
God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, Richard may come to an eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Before we go our separate ways, we take leave of Richard, physically. And that the prayers of our gathering express affection for him. And I trust it will ease our sadness, strengthen our hope. And our faith calls us that someday we will all be united again. And the love of Christ that conquers all things destroys even death itself. We first show a great respect of the human body. The incense is intended to give us a sense of the sublime, that we truly respect Richard, his physical presence. Into your hands, Father of mercy, we commend Richard with a sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise again. We thank you for the blessings that you gave him in life. We thank you and blessings that you gave to his family and friends. They are signs to us of your goodness and our fellowship. Our Lord, turn now to us. Hear the prayers of all gathered here. Open the gate of paradise to him. Let that spirit, that soul, be welcome to you, that we may comfort one another until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with him through Christ our Lord. Let us take him to a place of peace and rest.
Saved a wretch like me.
face to sing God's praise than when we first begun.
Doesn't turn off.